So recently I've been thinking, and I was thinking, I want to use my PVR to its fullest extent. I want to do videos that require more editing, more work, more research, and just take longer. You know, I want this to become a really big hobby. I want it to be, you know, take a while. I want it to be fun. I don't want to just slap together a video in 2 seconds. And I was thinking, because that's what Let's Plays are. They're really simple. They're like the simplest video I could possibly make. And I, you know, I'm just not using my PVR to its fullest extent. Which brought up this memory. Last summer, a friend of mine and I went to NeonCon 2013. I'm sure some of you know what it is, some of you probably don't. It was held at a community college, which he attends, and it was a really good experience. It really was. They had N64s and arcade machines set up that you could play. You know, they had all kinds of... The marketplace was huge. I mean, I'm talking 2 floors of a college building just with tables and tables upon tables of stuff you could buy. They had voice actors you could meet. I mean, free stuff everywhere. You couldn't walk down a hallway without seeing a table with free posters or anything like that. It was awesome. It was a really good experience. And even the stuff they had for sale wasn't that expensive. You know, they had, like, Mario and Luigi figures made out of beads that were glued together, and it was really cool, and they were only a couple bucks, which normally whenever you go to a big convention like that, stuff is really expensive. And it was a good experience. But there was one thing there. I mean, they even had a Pokemon conference and everything with trailers for the new season and everything. But there was one thing there that just... You decide for yourself how it was. About a half hour before the Pokemon conference, my friend and I we strolled past a room that said, how to make a Let's Play PowerPoint. 2:30 to 3:30 or something like that. So I'm like, my buddy's like, hey, you want to go in there? You make Let's Plays, you know, and we still have another half hour until the Pokemon conference. I'm like, meh, sure. Well, you know, what else are we going to do? So we go in there, and it was just starting. It was right about when it was starting. And as soon as I get in there, he starts up this PowerPoint. Now, nothing against him, you know, but this was the worst PowerPoint I have ever seen. The text was almost always the same color as the background. He used clip art that you would see on, like, a second grade art project. And there was no grammar. No apostrophes, no commas, no periods, no capitalization. It's an overall lack of grammatical skills. So, anyways, you know, it was bearable, because he was basically saying everything that was on the PowerPoint, obviously, as you do. So, you know, it wasn't that bad. But some of the stuff he was saying, the very first point he made was, you know, if you're using Audacity or any other voice recording program, you need to make sure that the audio is lined up with the video. Which is understandable, it makes sense. Yeah, it does. You know, that's what you gotta do. But he went on for about 5 or 10 minutes with all these strategies for making sure everything's lined up. Like, saying 1, 2, 3 and scrolling through the menu or pause menu and making sure that, you know, the audio lined up with the scrolls. And then he had another one which was, you know, just watch the video, place the audio, you know, by ear, make sure everything's alright, blah, 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 blah. And then he says this. This is something that I guess is for people who don't have any common sense. If everything else is lined up, audio-wise, but your reaction is late to only one or two things, maybe that's just you having a delayed reaction. You think? You think maybe it's just them having a delayed reaction? And as if that wasn't facepalm worthy enough, someone speaks up right then and there saying, oh yeah, I had that happen once. I was being attacked by a golem in Minecraft, and I had a kind of delayed reaction because something distracted me. And I moved the audio back so that was lined up, and then I posted it to YouTube, and then I rewatched it, and I realized that everything was ahead of the time except for my golem attack. And I had to take it down and repost it. First off, it's called watching your video before you post it. Second of all, common sense would tell you that if only one thing is off, that would be you having a delayed reaction, especially if you remember that something distracted you. He even said outright something distracted him. There's two fixes for your problem right there. Now, I didn't stay much longer, But then he started saying what games you should let's play. He said, classic games. And then he had a picture of an NES and a Dreamcast on the slide. NES maybe, so, you know, because you have an emulator, you can emulate it and, you know, use Fraps or whatever you have there. But Dreamcast games? Now, I follow a lot of Let's Players. Now, I keep my subscriptions private, just because I would spam you guys with subscribe to, because I subscribe to, like, 10 people every day. But I follow at least 40 to 50 Let's Players. That is not even an exaggeration. I don't think I've ever seen one of them play a Dreamcast game. And this guy's recommending it as if it's the holy grail of Let's Plays. So, you know, right there is kind of a lack of research, which I thought was kind of funny. And I spoke, and, you know, he was just over-analyzing everything, making Let's Plays way more complicated than they need to be. I spoke up. I said, you know, I know a lot of you guys are taking this serious. I know you guys maybe hope to get monetized in the future. Who knows? And I said, but Let's Plays are extremely simple. You talk over a video game, and maybe it wasn't this harsh sounding. I probably worded it different. This is just, like, basically saying what I said. You talk over a video game, and you have a good time, and you post it. I said, I make Let's Plays all the time. I said, you don't have to, you know, make sure... I mean, most of the time, Let's Plays aren't taken very seriously. It's not like an Easter egg video, you know, with tons of editing and stuff. It's not like that. I said, you know, now I'm not sure where this PowerPoint is going, but you just spent 15 minutes talking about how to line your audio up. It just seems like you're really overcomplicating things. He goes, oh, it's not that simple. Some guy in the audience there goes, oh, it's not that simple. It's not that simple. You know, you gotta do more than that. Okay, I don't make Let's Plays. I told him, I said, all right, yep. Not like I haven't made 1,200 subscribers. I think I'm up to 1,400 now, but at the time I had like 12. Yep, I haven't got 1,200 subscribers from Let's Plays or anything. But, well, I didn't say that. I was thinking it. I just said, okay. I'm just like, okay. Whatever. I don't know anything about Let's Plays. Not like I post them all the time. Whatever. Anyways, maybe I hold a little bit too much of a grudge against the guy. But anyways, it was just kind of comical. You know, Let's Plays are supposed to be fun. They're supposed to be the simplest videos that you could make. I left after a while. I only stayed for like 20 minutes. I don't know where the rest of the 40 minutes was going, because the whole time he was talking about audio and audio only. Oh, and then, you know, obviously then telling you what kind of games to play, but, because yes. I don't really like Sonic Adventures for the, or any of that one Sonic game for the Dreamcast, but I'm gonna play it, because he says it'll get me tons of views. Well, like I said, any amount of research will tell you that Dreamcast Let's Plays don't do very well on YouTube. And this guy's making a PowerPoint, in which I'm sure he was paid to do, about it. Good job. Anyways, guys, that's gonna have to be it. I'm sorry this video isn't HD, like my last vlog. I'm just recording it with my iPad, reason being I'm gonna go record some footage for a Let's Play. Or not. I can't even talk. I talk too much about Let's Plays. For a different kind of video, not a Let's Play, but some sort of video, which you guys will find out what it is. And before I go, I'd also like to mention that video I just posted, Outside the Map, Warhawk. I would really, really appreciate it if some of you subscribers would just at least go back there and check it out. You don't have to give it a like. You don't have to comment. Heck, if you don't like it, click off of it. You don't have to watch the whole thing. But I would I did put a lot of time into that video. I did put quite a bit of time learning my way around the editing system, you know, finding these things manually. I didn't look this stuff up on the internet. This was finding stuff manually. And then I recorded a bunch of other maps, too. So, like, overall, recording that day was around 3 or 4 hours. So, like I said, if you don't like it, click off of it. You don't have to leave a like. You don't have to comment. Just check it out. That's all I ask. You know, normally I don't beg for views. I don't beg for likes. But this video, I was a little bit disappointed when I seen it hasn't been doing too well the last few days as compared to my other videos. So, sorry if it sounds like I'm begging, but I would just really appreciate it if you guys could check that out. Anyways, guys, I will see you later.